Hi, Pat. How are you?
Hello, Sid. I'm good. What about
Great.
you?
I'm okay. All right. How was your year 2020 considering the pandemic?
Yeah, my 2020 was always, challenging, but I'm just grateful that I met my community, my family online, and I would always consider them a blessing because they really helped me a lot. So even if 2020 was really tough for everyone, I'm still optimistic. I'm still hopeful about things because at the end of the day, being optimistic is always good. So
That's
yeah.
true. Okay. How did you get into Uptrend? Like, were you introduced or you like stumbled across it?
Yeah. I met Uptrend actually through a friend from my Facebook group, and she's very she really encouraged me to join because at first I was really skeptical about it. I told her I don't want to waste my time engaging online because there was so much negativity, I don't want to waste another time. And then she said, just give it a try because it's basically a blogging, and she knows that I like to write. So I told her, okay, maybe I would like to check on it, but not really being serious about it. So I was amazed. I remembered I signed up around 2 o'clock in the morning. Both of my boys were already sleeping and I'm still awake. And I was struck with the community actually, because the feeling of how do I say, you have a family at once. So I told myself, okay, maybe Uptrennd is also a good one. And yeah, when I dig deeper, I check about Uptrennd, I research about it. It's really a good platform.
Okay. Your thoughts on downvotes. I mean, do you feel the value of a downvote should be half the value of an upvote? Like, for example, a downvote is 1 point, an upvote is 2 points. Like, what's your thoughts?
I remembered when I was chosen as one of the Gamma students. We discussed downvotes and upvotes. For me, downvote is how do I say? A baby. Babies normally they don't. You have to guide them because there are things that they are doing, which is not good for them. So downvote those who are not doing well on the platform, like those who are, like I say, spamming the platform. They need to be taught the proper way. And I believe downvote is a good way, a logical way to teach them that. With regard to the points, I think it's fair enough if, like you mentioned, yeah. But for me, like I said, my view on downvotes, like I mentioned, it's a way of helping them out or teaching them the proper way how to use the platform, not only Uptrend, with any other platforms that they will be joining themselves. Because the way I've seen it, like I said, with a baby, you have to teach them because definitely they are not really aware of what they are doing on the platform, and they are not helping. They are not helping. So we have to help one another, and downvote is one way to really remind them. Yeah, really remind them that they should do well on the platform.
Okay. What are your expectations of Uptrend going forward?
I was watching an interview done by Jeff to Roger back in library, and just today actually, and I was amazed because he was really very optimistic as well with the platform. And for me, I'm always positive about things, like regardless of people are saying, they are leaving Uptrend, they are considering other platforms because other platforms are better than Uptrend. But honestly, the way I've seen things, my expectations for Uptrend is always a positive one because there are still people coming in, and we have the value of the platform that I've seen other platforms don't have. And there was one crypto influencer, actually, he mentioned that Uptrend is really, you know, like I said, the value that we have on the platform is something that is unique within us. So my expectations would always be like, you know, always be positive, always be good thing. Because I mean, nobody wants to expect something not good, right? So
true.
Despite people saying something like, you know, Uptrend is like this, they are not earning well or whatever, at the end of the day, you know, at the end of the day, I would say Uptrend is my family. Uptrend is, you know, Uptrend University is, you know, they are good people. And you would rarely see these kind of people. You would, like I said, I've been using other blogging platforms, but I would say Uptrend is really one of the best that I have joined so far. Because the community that we have, we have this kind of family that other platforms don't have, actually. For me, personally. So, yeah, my expectations would always be, you know, positive. Always be good. Yeah.
Okay, on a final note, what's your plan for this year and beyond?
Actually, because, you know, living overseas is quite a challenge for me. Even if I've been overseas for like nearly 9 years now.
Wow.
But I always miss home. Yeah, I always miss my family in the Philippines. So plans, definitely, hopefully we can travel again. And things will be, you know, things will be better. And things will be back to how, it might not be the same how it was, but things will be getting better instead of going backward. So for the meantime, just for my plan for this year, hopefully we could, you know, go back to things like traveling and do things like the normal we did prior to the whole COVID thing. So yeah.
Well, all I gotta say that thanks so much for giving me your time on this Sunday.
Thank you, Susie. Thank you. I haven't watched the full version you had with Kenny Chu.